Hello dear viewers and greetings from the Brecon Beacons in Wales.
Today we will be taking a quick look at some of the attractive places in Wales I used to visit when I lived there. And it is always a pleasure to go back, as it is said that once you live in Wales, Wales lives inside you forever.
Hi there. Now continuing from our last episode in which I started to speak about the clothing that I'm wearing when I'm riding, because some of you asked questions of what I use, this week we'll be speaking about my heated gloves that I use from Blazewear. Now I've used these Blazewear heated gloves in the last couple of winters, and they were an excellent solution to keep my hands warm both with and without using the battery compartment, and in the winters to come I plan to use some of the other things that they have. Blazewear has, like the heated vest and so on, and try some of the other things just to see how it goes. And the reason why I got these is just simply because they cost something like £40 at the time that I bought them, and that was much cheaper than anything else I could buy at the time, which was for motorcycles. And then the great thing about it is that it has this compartment here in the back where you can put your batteries, so there's no cables that go to like the battery of the motorcycle. I had in the past some motorcycle gloves which were connected to the motorcycle battery, and within I think something like 2 years I had to send it back 3 times for repair, because I would always short circuit against the motorcycle or something would break and so on. And then I got fed up with these cables dangling around and everything, and so I thought a much better solution would just simply be to get these gloves which have this compartment here in the back in which you can store batteries, 3AA batteries, which will keep the helmet, which will keep the glove warm for something like 4 hours on average. Yeah, if you need it for longer, just simply take more batteries with you. But they're easy to charge, and so they do the job perfectly. Now, in all honesty, this is being sold as a skiing and winter glove, and how it will perform as a motorcycle glove if you have a crash at 70 miles per hour, I don't know. But then, of course, we don't know that sometimes about some other equipment out there, and whatever else could happen at 70 miles per hour. But this motorcycle glove has done the job for me so far, and I'm very happy with it. I would recommend, from my own experience, not to put these into like the tumble dryer and so on. So rather more, if you do want to wash them, rather more hand wash them, and they'll last you for quite a while. So there you have it, the Blazewear heated glove. The excellent, cheap and simple solution to your winter riding needs and making sure your hands stay warm.
The KTM you saw in the video was my 640 adventure, nicknamed Camel Spirit 640, which served me well while living in London in 2003 and then in Wales. The heated gloves I used at the time were useful when riding in the winter, providing they worked, and allowed me to explore Wales and everything it had to offer. From Caerphilly Castle and the off-road tracks near the Romney Valley to the mountains of Snowdonia, Wales has a lot for the eye to feast on. I wanted to add location tracks of these off-road possibilities for your GPS, but I'm not sure if these lanes are still open. So instead, I have provided in the comment section below the contact details for local off-road clubs if you want some legal off-roading there. You will not be disappointed. I especially recommend the Elan Valley because of its remoteness and peaceful silence. In the next episode, we will look at the knee pads I use and start looking into some of the byways in England where you can practice your off-road skills. See you then!